What's going on, everybody? It's Faye, dating coach Elliot Scott, and as you can see, I am in my cousin's car. Actually, she is getting some teeth taken out, and it's coronavirus, right? I have my mask here. I can't sit in the waiting room, so I'm gonna sit in the car. And why not make a video like old school, right? Now, as you can see by the title below, we're going to talk about getting a guy to chase, and I want to talk about some philosophies that have to do with it. And this might be a lengthy video, right? I hope it's not, but there is a lot to talk about. And I might jump all over the place, but I hope you get something out of it, okay? So here's the thing. Well, first off, if you haven't yet, please subscribe. Just click the red button below. I'll love you forever. And if you want to work with yours truly, have a one-on-one session. Link is down in the description. So I'm a big believer that women have to get men to chase. A man has to chase to some degree, okay? Now, when I say that, where women, I think, go wrong 99% of the time is I think she's making a man chase more than what he actually values her as. And I know that sounds horrible, and it sounds like, you know, consumer culture, and it sounds like I'm objectifying a woman, that she's an object, she can't be bought. I agree 100%. You can be convinced, though, but you can't be bought. However, it's important to understand that if a guy... See, you know, if you're trying to sell, and I use this analogy all the time, if you're trying to sell me an iPhone for $2,000, and I know I can get it for $1,200, or I know that an iPhone is $1,200, then I'm not going to do it, okay? I'm not going to do it. At the same time, if you sell it less than that, you sell it for $700, I'm going to think something's up. Like, really? Like, this is too good to be true. I don't, you know. So, I always tell women, you have to make a man chase based on what you believe your value is. And please, I know ladies in the comments are going to say, this is horrible advice. This is the problem with men and dating and society and this. And no, it's not. It's not. It's actually the truth, the hard truth that no one wants to tell you, because everyone wants to believe they're special and unique in some way when men and women across the board are completely average, because everything's subjective, right? No one's that special. Women, no guy is so special that you should be crying over him for 3 months. No girl is so special that a guy should be chasing her again for 3 or 4. No, no one's that special, okay? Unless they're like the soulmate, the one. That's just not the case. So I tell women, you gotta base it on your value. And I always use a metric where I say, if you make it too hard, right? He's not going to chase. He's like, it's not worth it, right? No, no way. If you make it too easy, he's going to take you for granted. Now, when it comes to chasing, a lot of men, if this is a video for men, men are going to be like, what? I'm not going to chase no woman. And I agree with that to an extent, right? But men, if you're watching this, you have to understand too that a woman is not entitled to a man's resources. He has to offer them to her. So he has to choose her. He has to say, and I say choose because, this is where it's going to go back and forth. Women value sex more, right? Because women just don't sleep around with a bunch of dudes. They know this is what men are after. So women should be, in my opinion, the more choosier sex, where lower value men or the average guy, he's more the offerer. Men love sex. Men will have sex with anybody. They're going to offer, okay? But when it comes to long-term, longevity, a man is going to choose a woman, and a woman is going to choose a man in the sense that a woman, you know, women are always like, a man needs to court me. A man needs to do this. I guess so. I mean, if that's your criteria to get a guy to come, or, you know, for a guy to prove himself, that's fine. Nothing wrong with that. But you are not entitled to a man's resources. If he doesn't want to invest in you, he doesn't have to invest in you. And on the flip side, a woman should never feel obligated. A woman should never feel forced or guilty for not putting out, because a man is not entitled to her egg. okay? So that's where now reciprocal investment comes in. And this is where I tell women that a lot of the times, if you want a man, you know, a lot of women nowadays are like, a man needs to invest. I don't want to ever reach out. I shouldn't have to reach out. He should be reaching out. No, the one who likes the other one more is the one who should be reaching out, okay? And it should balance out overall. Your hope, if a woman reaches out more in the beginning, you're hoping to reach out to get him attached or attracted to you to where now he's reaching out more and it's balancing out, okay? Or vice versa. But guys, as you women know, okay, so let me give you a good example. Women always come to me, why does he show a lot of interest in the beginning and then pull away? What's going on here? Well, he's doing exactly what I said women should do. He's investing heavily. And he's hoping that investment pays off. He's investing, he's painting this picture, he's love bombing you, or whatever you ladies want to call it, love bombing, future faking. I wouldn't even say it's future faking, because sometimes they don't fake it, they just lose attraction. And, sorry, I'm moving around so much, my hands are very tired. And, you know, you get attracted, okay, which means his investment pays off, and now you're addicted, or you're attracted to him, and he pulls back a little bit, and you're wondering, like, well, what the hell happened? He played the game correctly there. But overall, we like reciprocal investment. I think a man and a woman should invest in each other equally. I personally think a man should invest a little more in the beginning, 60, 40, or 55, 45. But ladies, let me tell you something. It depends on value and depends on what the man's looking for. If you're investing in a dude, or if a guy's investing in you and you're playing this hard to get bullshit, it ain't gonna work. It is not gonna work. A high value man will walk away in a heartbeat. We like reciprocal investment, because if he's a high value dude, whatever you can offer him, he can get somewhere else. He has what a lot of women want. If there's a high value guy out there, okay, a 9 or a 10, and he's looking for a relationship, he's highly sought after amongst women. Because guess what? A lot of dudes who are 9 or 10s, they don't want relationships because they can focus on quantity. They can attract a lot of women. So this guy can have his pick of the litter. Right now, of course, that doesn't mean a woman doesn't have value. She absolutely does, and things like that. But both sexes like reciprocal investment. Men like to know that their investment that they're putting in a woman is going to have a payoff. That doesn't mean sex, just interest, IOIs, indicators of interest in each other. And if that goes accordingly, right, if these are both happy, healthy people who are looking for relationships and don't BS each other and they're not emotionally unavailable, things will work out grand, okay? It will go back and forth, they'll be honest with each other, and it should transition to a relationship. But so many times, what I see women do wrong is one of the following. They make a man work too hard, and he's like, no. Right? Nice try. Or she gives in too easily. A guy shows some interest. He paints this beautiful picture and she just melts. And then a guy takes advantage of the situation. Not on purpose all the time. I mean, there's some piece of shits out there who are like, yeah, I just want to hit and quit. But then there's just some guys out there who were like, you know what? I thought I wanted a relationship. I didn't. Or I like her. Maybe I painted the wrong picture. Whatever, you know? But ladies, if you want to get a man to invest, never invest more than he's investing in you, okay? Invest the same. And if he's pulling away a little bit, you either pull away also. I would call his ass out on it and cut it short. Or cut him short if you're not getting standards. That's where standards come in. But that's beside the point. It's reciprocal investment. You invest in each other based on your value. You should only invest in him what you think his value is worth. And of course, you're being humanly humane, or, you know, kind to each other. Like, you treat them like a human. Don't be a piece of shit to each other. And if you do that, things should work out, you would think, right? But that's how it is, ladies. It's based on your value, based on your standards, and reciprocal investment, what you're giving each other, okay? So with that being said, I love you all. Take care, stay safe, and peace. Wait, shit, did I push it?